we're turning our attention to the top of the men's singles draw. Fifth match of the day here on semi-finals day. Day five in Chengdu. And on walks Chen Long against his fluffy-haired opponent today, Tanonsak Tien Sombunsak from Thailand. So we are right at the top of the draw now. Lin Dan awaits the winner, as we suggested just now. Chen Long. Well, there he is. Let's listen to what the umpire has to say.
You want red? It's red, you call.
You see?
You serve.
So Chen Long will serve, having not won the coin toss, but he elected to choose the end. Chen Long, the undisputed world number one. 22 career singles titles to his name. Five that he won in 2015, the Danish Open, Korea Open, World Championships, of course. And in the Astora Stadium, Jakarta, Chinese Taipei as well. That was a great year for him. But, and there is a but, in 2016, he's titleless so far, which by his lofty standards mean that he's slightly off colour. His confirmation, 27 years of age. A man born in Hubei, resident in Beijing. And this young man, born and resides in Bangkok, Thailand. 25 years old. Currently ranked 33rd in the world. Has been as high as 9th in the world back in November 2013. But rather like Chen Long, frankly, hasn't been up to a lot this year. Let's just examine closely the head-to-head showing. 9-0 in favor of Chen. Last meeting was in the Victor Korean Open last year in the first round. That again was in straight games, but in his defense, Tanonsak has taken a game twice from Chen Long and taken him the distance, detained him on court for a little longer. That was in the Denmark Open and the Indonesian Open of 2014. But he's still 9-0 down head-to-head. So Chen Long, despite being up in that regard, will be very respectful of his opponent, I'm sure. But his last tournament win himself was in October of last year, the Denmark Open, beating Tommy Sugiarto in the final there. 2016 results, well, not an awful lot to show, really. Final of the Malaysian Open for Chen Long, lost to Lee Chong Wei in 42 minutes in that final. Benny Zhu presiding over this one. And service judge Fan Hibble. Chen Long to get us underway in the last of today's semi-finals. You're in the company of Paul Hand. Great to have you along. Wow. Well, we don't have the luxury of Hawkeye out here at this Grand Prix gold level event. But that was deemed to land in right on the edge of the line by our replay. Now this man in red has jaw-dropping athleticism. He really is a standout athlete. And when you get close, as I did in the Astora Stadium, to watching him live, it really is something to behold. It just leaves you dribbling, frankly, in awe, because he just has such phenomenal end-range control. And just when you think you've got him in a little bit of a hole on the court, he comes out with on cue, defensive brilliance like that. Watch this, it was a good smash from Tanonsak. but to no avail in the end. Wonderful block by Chen Long. And where most players in that situation getting up to that forehand net shot there. Most players, when they're tired, sort of fatigue and bend from the back. Not so with Chen Long. He's so strong in the legs that he keeps his head still. He's really balanced and so often manages to turn those arduous situations around into attack. And like Lin Dan, there's an ease and a grace about the way that he does things. I don't think he has quite the... And this is not demeaning of him in any way, because Lin Dan is such an excellent player to watch. But I don't think he quite has the extreme level of hand skills of Lin Dan. But what he does is have exceptional athleticism.
5-1.
His results this year, second round at the All England Open, lost to Zhu Song, 21-19, 21-17 in 49 minutes. That was a surprise for everybody, and the All England were hoping to get the Lin Dan Chen Long final, but it didn't happen. Lost in the final of the Malaysian Open, as I said, to Li Chong Wei, 21-13, 21-8 in 42 minutes, and quarterfinals of the Singapore Open to Ng Kar Lang in 39 minutes. Well, there's a big plus for Chen Long in this match as well. At least he's going to be familiar should he come through here, as indeed the scoreboard and the head-to-head showings of the past 9-0 indicate he probably will. And the plus is that he's going to be playing another left-hander tomorrow. Lin Dan has inked his name into the final berth at the very bottom of the draw as the second seed.
8-1.
But it's all Chen Long at the moment. Inside out smash. And a respectful applause from the crowd for the Thai player, and 12th seed in this event. So we've already witnessed Li Jure through as top seed in the women's singles in straight games. Indeed, all of our matches today, all the semi-finals so far, have been straight games. Su Chan and Ma Jin in the mixed doubles, they came through as well. Oh. Lin Dan, 21-13, 21-15 through in just 40 minutes against Lin Guipu of China, the young 19-year-old. Then we saw Li Yongdae and Yu Yongxun of Korea as top seeds come through in 38 minutes against Huang and Zheng of China. And our generous offering of multiple world number ones on display today here. Bonnie, China Masters. Oh, he's always got the last laugh. But leaving nothing to chance, he's very respectful, very humble. And he doesn't want to allow an in for Tanonsak. Must be delighted when he saw the draw, knowing his head-to-head, I'm sure, against Anunsuk. It's a player who doesn't quite have the armory to really dent Chen Long. You need an awful lot of power. And also, you need to take the shuttle very, very early to rush the big man. That was wonderfully read. He's a man of talent, the Thai player. Just a little lightweight, some would suggest, at this, the highest level. That said, he did manage 3 years or so ago to oust his way into the top 10. Career high of 9th in the world, November 2013. 然后就是你后场给高球也好，从软件给后场也好，就这个准备传。他有时候抡起来一拍打你。So 11-3 as we head to the mid-game interval then after just 8 minutes play. Chen Long, as anticipated, in the driving seat of this one already.
啊，一直给他。
And if this continues, we're going to be treated to that real popcorn match tomorrow. Lin Dan against Chen Long. What a spectacle that will be.
20 seconds.
Clash of the Titans. An indulgence that not many tournaments are afforded. The All England Open didn't get it. And I, for one, are looking forward to really savouring it, should we be graced with it. Spilling wide, according to the Lions judge. A very assured performance from Chen Long, who, like Lin Dan, as the top two seeds, never appears rushed on a badminton court. Except then, good play from Tununsak, who has that sort of languid lefty feel to his game, as Lin Dan does as well, but he doesn't quite have the power of Lin Dan. So only one semi-final showing this year from Tununsak. In the Thai Masters, quarterfinals of the Swiss Open, very respectfully. Three first round losses, including the Singapore Open last week, and two round of 16s, the Malaysian Open and the Indian Open for the Thai player, 12th seed here. Oh, that's a poor leave. It was in.
54.
Let's take a look again on the replay. Plum on the line. Great tumbling net shot to set up the point.
Service over.
Almost a sympathy applause from the crowd, who are aware of this thankless task that he's facing against Chen Long, who really is an imposing force. Well played. Two in a row then for Tununsuk.
15.
Number 2, the first round of the 女子双打比赛, Wang Dongping, Zhong Jianxi,
Well, I can tell you that over on the adjacent court, they're on to their final match of the day, as we are here on court one. It's going to be a women's doubles. Huan and Zhong, and Chen and Zhao.
Umpire Li Yan, China.
Quick to close. Again, using all the power in those quads and calves, just laden with muscle, but not overly so. Strong, yet agile at the same time. So Nonsack reducing the deficit. But it's got an academic feel about it, especially when you have done your homework and looked at that head-to-head showing. So 12 points ahead. Chen Long now, the top seed, closing in on this opening game.
Set is over. Seven, eight,
well, a shake of the head and a irritated look back to his camp, or his coach, suggesting that he's not altogether pleased with that backhand. Oh, it's out. Good leave from Tan Nonsack.
Eight,
but there's a contented purr around the Olympic Sports Center Xincheng at the moment. All of our semifinals decided in straight games, very closely contested straight games, most of them. But a real hush around the stadium. They've had their fill of badminton yesterday. Matches started 5 o'clock local time.
Service over. 19,
9. So 6 out of the 11 years China's had a shutout of the medals. Home fans earlier today were giddy with excitement, loving it. Crowd very much engaged, but now it's a changed atmosphere. Tan Nonsack turned that point around really well. A little bit of a switch off in concentration for Chen Long, and a wry smile as a consequence. He knew he had that point done and dusted, just missing the final slice. Good tight net shot from Tan Nonsack there. Nine game point opportunities then for Chen Long now, after just 15 minutes played.
Set is over. 12, 20.
Thank you. well wide, that lift from Chenlong.
13,
two game 20. Points recovered by Tun On Sak. Chenlong generally does everything that Tun On Sak does, but just that little bit better in most departments. I hope you'll agree. But that's why he's world number one, hey? Tun On Sak's 33rd ranked in the world.
14, 20.
Well, three in a row for Tun On Sak, which bodes well going into game two, if nothing else. Still six game point opportunities for Chenlong. Nice finish.
15, 20.
And he has to play tight to lines to contest these points against the world number one, that's for sure. But that's four in a row for the young Thai. It's about now that most mere mortals sort of fatigue and tire, but Chenlong, look at the physicality. He's nudged tight into all four corners, and he still comes out smelling of roses as he seals the opening game. He went the long way round. He came through 21-15 then, after 18 minutes played. So, controlled badminton, that's what it's all about. Each player will have probably 8 to 12 rackets in their bag as they change ends. After inside 20 minutes then, it's the top seed in commanding form out here. He's in menacing mood. Not so at the back end of that opening game, but until then, very strong surge from Tun On Sak. Now, can he put this together and start this second game the way he ended the last game? Grand Prix events are gaining much popularity. 14 Grand Prix gold events selected for the circuit this year, showcasing world-class badminton talent from locations such as Bangkok, here in Jiangsu Province, London, New York, Saarbrücken, Taipei City.
Hot one, 20 seconds.
So, Tun On Sak from Thailand. Build on the back end of that opening game where he played some really inspired badminton. Challenge Chenlong.
Second game. Level play.
Game two, Chenlong to serve at the top of your picture in red. Other events left this year to go. Chinese Taipei Open Grand Prix Gold and US Open Grand Prix Gold. Indonesian Masters, Thailand Open, Bitburger Open in Germany, of course, Korean Masters, and the Macau Open as well. They're the other eight events left in this Grand Prix Gold series before the end of the year. Opportunity for players to amass some decent prize money. Minimum prize fund $120,000 US. Here it's up to 150,000. And it would have been a super serious event, but of course they host the China Open, and the country can only have one super series event. So this one got the downgrade. But that said, always well attended. They always attract a very strong field. No less than in the men's singles, Chen Long and Lin Dan. Both within the top three players in the world rankings. Winners in the men's singles event so far. Well, Malaysian Masters was won by Lee Chong Wei. Syed Mori by Srikanth. Kadambi Srikanth. Thai Masters, Lee Hyun Il of Korea. Lin Dan won the German Open. And the New Zealand Open was won by Huang Yuxiang of China. Good start for the Thai player here. For those of you just joining us, I can confirm that Lin Dan has inked his place into the final at the bottom half of the draw, and he's just awaiting the outcome of this one to see who he plays. Looks, well, it did look at the end of that first game like it was going to be Chen Long, definitely, but Tonopsak, spirited fight back here. He's on a mission. It's four in a row for the Thai player. He's a man of real talent, the lefty. Rather Lin Dan-like in that regard. But he just can't put it together consistently enough at the highest level, as so few can, to be fair. Tight net shot from Chen Long to reduce the deficit to just three. So strong in that situation when he's below the tape, so poised and balanced, using his opposite arm for balance, and those strong quads able to hold his head still so he gets a good look at the shuttle. Complete control. Oh, good close.
Service over. Six.
That's been a real big feature of this match, the cross or straight net shots from both, just so tight. Nice slice. Coach G-ing him on as if to suggest, don't get complacent. Come on, we've got work to do here. And of course, this is all about coming through this match from Chen Long's perspective in straight games so that he can contain some of that energy. He'll need it tomorrow against Lin Dan, that's for sure. Fine example, the world number one, of trying to stay in balance at all costs. Otherwise, it's impossible to play quality shots. And he really is physically a brilliant athlete. There was a good example of that. Just so strong in the legs and core to close this space down and take advantage of that situation. Watch this. Boom. Bit of hang time in the air above the net there. Didn't take his eyes off the shuttle. bit too greedy there, Chen Long, with that one. To Nonsax, Steez keeps his advantage. Bit of fan can there for those two players. Conditioning paramount in singles, of course, with the rally resilience and tenacity. It's such a test of will, war of attrition, death by a thousand cuts, if you will. When you're playing a player like Chen Long, you've got to be prepared to stay out there all day. It's always going to be a physically grueling contest. It just pins you into the four corners and wears you down. He's also got thunderous pace when he needs it on that smash. What? It's a brilliant point from the Thai player and a wry smile from the Chinese coach. A nice deep lift from Chen Long, but not so that one. Well, in their last nine meetings, he's managed to take a game twice from Chen Long. He certainly has the talent to do so. It's just whether he can put it together concentration-wise to do just that. But he's a handful to Nonsack. Very talented player.
Sun is over.
9-6. And in keeping with the back end of that opening game, he's kept concentration very, very well, the left-hander. And he's pummeled that one down the line on a few occasions of late with great effect. Here he is then, serving 9-6 up. Well, the wonderful slice sets up the point, hands down from the Lions judge, indicating that it did clip the line. We're going to see in our replay how close it was. Look at that wonderful slice there, the way the shuttle just dropped like a stone. Well, Tanunsek thought that was out. He might have a case. Very close. Cool stance. That was on the line as well.
Seven, 10.
So. Two straight points then for Chen Long.
Service over.
A bit of a lapse in concentration from Chen Long, and combine that with some brilliance from Tanonsak, and suddenly the game has come alive. And, Tanonsak will be delighted that at the mid-game interval, he's 11-7 up here. That'll really fill him with confidence, you'd imagine. And just when Chen Long was hoping and his coach to close out the match, he's been denied so far and detained on court for longer than we anticipated. Tanonsak's managed to generate a run of 4 points. as he did in the opening game as well. But Chen with plenty of work to do here. 4 points adrift after half an hour played, but he is the game up, of course. The shuttle will need replacing. Chen Long in that point, he was up against it because Konontsek was bringing his best, managing to turn this one round beautifully with a wonderful forehand block there. Again, strong poise and balance around the backhand. Straight net shot from Chen. Watch this. Look at that for control. That's masterful. And a glare as he tries to impose his character onto the Thai player. Good round head smash. What a majestic athlete, so strong in those legs.
11.
Hunting the shuttle magnificently here. Watch this. Konontsek just deceptive in every regard. The racket blown out of his hand by the world number one, who's won, I believe, three in a row. Yes, it is. So from 7-11 to 10-11. Yep, it's the luck of the net court though, Konontsek.
Wow.
To pierce Chen's momentum bubble. Ah, he earned that, that was very good. Again, the smash is finding its mark. That one down to the backhand corner of Chen. Just mixing it nicely. Really got hold of it, though. Nice weighty shot. And then look at the follow-up. So quick to close and take time and space away from Chen Long. He's delighted with that one. Again, but look at this from Chen Long. Wonderful point. Up a little too high for a man as focused and athletic as the world number one. That's meat and drink. So Chen Long doing very well to stay in touch with an in-form Konontsek from Thailand. change of mind from Chen Long there, you feel. And despite the run of two, Tenunsak managed to win that point to increase his margin to 2 points ahead again this game. Chen Long throwing the kitchen sink at him, trying to turn this one around, but he's remained resilient and admirably so, just showing some real brilliance. So concerning times these for Chen Long. Tough to get a read over the Thai player. That's wide as well. So 3 points ahead now then, Tenunsak. The crowd are igniting again. Now, will we see order being restored in this game? It's a real test of Chen Long's ability here. Fatigue setting in that rally, you'd imagine.
13, 15.
That's when the hand skills start to wilt. It was close, hit the tape, but coming down the wrong side for the tie. You'd imagine he would be really excited about Ratchanok Intanon's progress lately with the three Super Series consecutive wins, a feat never achieved before in the women's or men's game. She did last week by winning the Singapore Open. Amazing. Well, it's said that she's working extremely hard. And that's what this man in picture is very good at doing. He has an extremely high pain threshold. You don't get a body like that without doing so. He has not shunned the work, that's for sure, as he's clawing his way back, you feel, into this second game. 39 minutes played, and the physicality starting to show from Chen Long. Body language supreme. These stern tests make you stronger as a player. That's a beautiful tumbling net shot from Tenunsak. His fans and friends delighted. Look at that for exquisite. Good recovery there from Chen, but look at that. That's just unplayable. It's like Tenunsak's throwing caution to the wind and throwing that head-to-head showing out the door, saying, and disrespectfully, playing some brilliant badminton. 3 points ahead this game. And if this continues, we're going to be treated to a deciding game. Look at his body language. He's excited. A man of real talent. Just going for the towel, needs to take his time, he knows so. Well, men's singles is all about control of the net, we know that. And Tenunsak with some beautiful tight net shots. And tumblers as well. There's a lot to look forward to in this match. It's unfolding nicely, the drama. Oh! Chen Long spills another error. Tenunsak's in. 2 points from levelling up this contest. Far from over. Tell you what, Chen Long really is having to bolster his defenses right now and play some really solid badminton with his go-to set plays that he can really depend upon right now, because Tan On Sak, well, playing some incredibly imaginative badminton. This is where Chen Long, you'd imagine, will get very, very physical and not yield and ask a lot of questions of Tan On Sak and make him take a lot of risks as well. A smile from the coach on looking. Manages to take charge of that point. Chen Long. Yeah, there's the short lift. They've got Tan On Sak in trouble there towards the end. Two points in a row then for Chen. For Chen Long, who's back on the warpath here, playing some very consistent high percentage badminton and using that strong frame, that that athletic prowess to force his way through this tight second game. Tan On Sak still with a 1 point advantage, though. Can he produce some brilliance? We've seen a lot of it in the second game. Oh, it was indeed called out, and I felt that as soon as it was struck. Umpire having none of it. Chen Long gesturing that indeed it cleared, it hit the line. I don't have the advantage of Hawkeye out here. No challenges at this Grand Prix Gold level. We can see the replay, they can't. Let's have a look. Straight down this line, I think. Very, very close. I would say more out than in, definitely. It might have clipped the edge, but I don't think so. I think that was a correct call. Anyhow, it will stand. And it does mean that the Thai player just 2 points from a deciding game. So, rightly, the purple-shirted Thai taking his time. He's in the driving seat. Can he see this game home? Well, a wince of disappointment after this one. Millimeters in it. Look at that. Almost perfection. Even Chen Long's facial expressions told its own picture. two game point opportunities to take this match and to decide again. It's a brilliant play from Tomotsak here, great defense. And the lift just misses. Look at what it means to him. He's excited, he wants more. I'll tell you one thing's for sure though, he's gonna be absolutely exhausted out there. He's had to leave it all out there in this second game. Will he have the physical resource to come through? Well, the last couple of three-game encounters were 21-19, 22-20 for Chen Long, so it's always close when he gets his teeth into it, but he really is a talent, the Thai. Found the line for that one, though. There is no call, despite a mini protest from Tomotsak. A shake of the head in frustration. It was a wonderful smash. Cross court, found the edge of the line, despite the gesture. So, he's still afloat. Now, will Tomotsak bring his dagger, stick it into the side of Chen Long's dinghy to sink him in this game? Metaphorically speaking, of course. Semi-final in the men's singles event. What a performance from the young Thai player. And what a reaction, more to the point.
这边呢还是这样打，不能啊，不顶手，不顶打。对呀，然后呢，手往里反，然后这样，然后呢，他这样，他就反在扑你，没有用，啊，下面别的正常，攻的一样就这样，一定要他凑出来球出来的时候，我抓他扑他。刚刚把我手腕甩了球，他推了半场，我想发力了，没打死。
对，你看有一个球起来，正常蹦，反而挺重的，啊，调整好自己节奏，还注意一下这个自己的连贯的给完后场以后下拍的速度，啊，精力调整好。
就宁愿要最后那种不要打死。
啊，对对对，
不要上去蹦蹦蹦搞两个失误两个失误。
那直接多拍攻死我没问题，啊，自己就还是前面说的给完后场和下拍精力集中。
看局啊，
看局
看局
打得好。
Well,
change in shirt, change in fortune, you know what they say. You've got to change something. That last game, well, I would say Chen Long didn't lose it, you know. He was just flat beaten. Tomotsak with some... and plenty of them. Sparkling, you know, sparkles of brilliance throughout that game from this player. But now, does he have the legs to see it through at the sharp end of this tournament?
Final game.
He's won four matches to get here. Indeed, they both have. No buys at all for the seeds in this one. And a 64-player draw. Takes his time. He must be delighted that he's detained the world number one for a third and deciding game. Chen Long to get us underway. Sorry, beg your pardon. Tomotsak, top of your picture. It's a really spirited point, building on the momentum from the second game from the mauve shirted Thai. Just when you expect Chen Long to bat down the defenses and give nothing, it's going to be a real war of attrition, this deciding game. Another flash of inspiration from Tan On Sak. He's doing very, very well to keep his nose in front here. He's very deceptive and tough to read. But there's a hush of disbelief around here now. Court two's all done and dusted. The women's doubles has been decided. Don't ask me who won. I've been too attentive on this match, really, to have paid any attention to that. Look at that wonderful tight net shot from Chen Long. Mesmerizing Babin to the second game. And, in keeping with that, this as well is pretty compelling. Nothing between them. Scoreboard symmetry now. Game all, 2 points all. Lips is that fatigue, or where are we at? Chen Long, we know what a sublime athlete he is. We just took a look at how cut he was, having taken his shirt off at the end of that second game and just ripped with muscle. And you'd have to imagine his body fat percentage would be certainly sort of lower than 10%. And that physical prowess generally would stand a player in great stead, but he's up against the miraculous hands of the talented lefty in the Thai player, the other end in mauve. Somewhere, no doubt, with his feet up, or you would imagine, anyhow, having stretched out, maybe had a massage, certainly a shower, and he'll be enjoying this as well, hoping that they stay out there until 30-28 or something like that in the deciding game, because, of course, he is already in the final, and he'll want to see the winner of this one fatigued. In. It was a poor lead by Chen Long.
Three, four.
And he will be disappointed there, because Tan On Sak hanging on for crumbs in this deciding game. And big difference between 5-2 and 4-3 psychologically, especially when the player in red had lost the second game. No big upsets or surprises on day two, certainly on court one anyway. But are we about to see an upset here? Not if Chen Long has his way, he's suggesting. Physicality paying off. Wonderful. Just saw the hole in the court and smashed it through to it. So day five nearing its conclusion then.
Service over, 4-5.
And again, Tenonsak stays in touch. Just the 1 point between them. As hard as Chen Long tries, he can't seem to pull away from the tie. So in a nutshell, summary of this so far, we've got the clever, imaginative left-handed, superb hand skills of the man in your picture up against the physical brute and awesome specimen of an athlete that is Chen Long, the world number one in red at the near end. He's found the line.
Service over.
And again,
five,
reduces the deficit to one. But you feel you'd have to make a break, really, to really put Chen Long under any sort of sustained pressure. Chen, so good in this situation. Slice, absolutely stunning. Watch this level of deception here. Look, sells in the down the line smash, and then wow, that is and he greets it with a smile of acknowledgement as well, as if to rub salt in the wounds of the Chinese fans and player. Still feel like there's a lot of badminton left in this one. Scoreboard parity again. That's better. You do feel that Chen Long is going to have to get just that little bit more aggressive, frankly, and bring the play to Nonsak. Take his time and space away and buckle those hand skills by rushing him into error. Run and set plays in training. It's a heavy price to pay, and a very driven individual to sustain that level of hard work throughout the years. But it's about now that it should pay off. But the brilliance from Tenonsak's racket continues.
7-8.
And he's always got that fluffy haired look, like a young chick that's just hatched out of the egg. But wow, does he play some sublime badminton. There's a hush of respect around the stadium as the crowd really don't know what's going to happen out here. Tenonsak doing a great job in dismissing any previous head-to-head thrashings.
Seven.
Way into the back of his mind. Suddenly, there it is.
Seven.
The errors started to come from Tononsak. Pressure building from the world number one's physical prowess. And the problem being, Tononsak realizes that he has to redline to win points. He has to play lights out. Chen Long, well, he lives at this tempo like a highly tuned racing car, if you will. And he heads to the mid-game interval with just that little bit more breathing room, a four-point cushion for the world number one. These are the edges that they train so hard for, these guys. Well, we've had something for everybody on today's rich and varied order of play. We've had a women's singles to kick us off, a mixed doubles, two men's singles, sandwiched in between the middle of those two. Look at the deception there from, was a men's doubles. This man has laughed it all out there, no doubt about it, and asked some serious questions of Chen Long. Chen Long resumes with serve, 11-7 in the deciding game.
Wow, seven.
4 in a row for the red-shirted world number one. So important you feel at this stage that after resumption, after the mid-game interval, that Tononsak resumes well if he's to contest this deep. Well, he's fighting tooth and nail for every point out here, but to no avail of late. It's all been Chen Long. It's 5 points in a row now. Gently, he's coming out of those net exchanges better of late. Needs to keep the pressure on here and stifle the fabulous hand skills of the Thai player. Oh. Impeccable accuracy on the smash. It was going on the line. Tononsak berates himself as if to say why they play that was going wide, but no, from here, I think that was going to pierce right through the line. Just that little bit more discipline, a little bit more patience, and that little bit more deep-seated self-belief from Chen Long at this stage. That's wonderful close as well, again, using the physicality. Kept on about it, but it is so prevalent at this level.
Eight.
seems the longer the rallies go now, that the redshirt top seed is favourable. Oh, ever alert with the backhand block.
16, 8.
Challenge fading now from Tononsak. That coupled with an increase in intensity from the world number one. And we've got an emphatic hold over this one. 16 points to 8. Oh, it was a poor leave.
Service over. 16.
Lift is on or inside the back line. Let's take a look at it on our replay. Oh, well inside. That's a poor mistake in judgment from number one. Uncharacteristic. Yep. Upping the power.
Service over.
Gets it done in the end. So we are 7 minutes over the hour mark on court now in this our fifth and deciding final semi-final of day five. Well, that was absolutely gorgeous hand skills from Chen Long, and again, testament to the fact that he is poised, balanced, head still, not hinging from the back, strong in the legs. Felt like Chen Long at this stage in the point had a vice-like control over it. Not so. Look at that beautiful lift that got him out of danger. Tumbling net shot from Tanunsa. Watch this. Going to get another look at it now on our replay. Look how tight that one was. Frustration over the face of the top seed. Right into the body of Chen here. Look at this. Good defense here. But that one, yeah, the body blow. Handcuffing Chen Long into mistake. Couldn't quite get it out of the meat of the racket. Well, there's no denying the rich talent of the Thai player. That's 4 points in a row, and just when you think the match is pretty much dead and buried with Chen Long being, what is he, just 3 points away, then this man decides to play some sparkling badminton. Make that five in a row now for Tononsak. And, you know, if this continues, Chen Long might, and I mean, it's a big, big, but he might get a little bit tight as we head towards the sharp end of this game because of that very issue. He's not having all his own way, and he is appreciative of the rich talents of this 25-year-old Thai player. This is a huge point in the overall context of this match. You can almost sense and visualize a pivot under the match. It's just seesawing around right now. Massive point. Touch from both there. Look at that. Tumbling net shot from the top draw from Chen Long. Frustration on one side of the net, delight on the other, but it's been a match played in great spirits. Chen Long now with a lead of 5-2 points away from an opportunity to play Lin Dan in the final tomorrow. Tomorrow, Lin Dan. It's going to be the all-Chinese final, and a real treat that I, for one, am so looking forward to. Popcorn match of the day for sure. We're going to be treated to Chen Long against Lin Dan. Safely through. Spirited performance from his opponent today, Tanon Tsak from Thailand, who beats a hasty retreat from the court. There's just confirmation of the score, 21-15, 19-21, 21-14 after 74 minutes. But it's Chen Long, the top seed, through. So just confirmation of the day's results then. You can see that Li Zhuru came through against Pontip. Zhu and Ma in the mixed doubles. Lin Dan as well through, and Lee and Yu, the Koreans, in the men's doubles, safely through to the final. And then just our final match, Chen Long winning 2-1 in games against Tanon Tsak of Thailand. So that just confirms our results today. So that pretty much concludes our action from semi-finals day here in Changzhou. We will leave you with some highlights. For more information, do go to bwf.com. It's finals day tomorrow. Do join us at 1 o'clock local time. The medal podiums beckon. So from myself, Paul Hand, it's goodbye for now. Do join us tomorrow. Thanks for your company.